Guess what came in the mail yesterday? Tweets from Tahrir. Tahrir Square, that is within Cairo, Egypt. It is an easy read because it's all in tweet. This is an extraordinarily intense book. If you want kind of light reading, you might want to stick with 50 Shades of Grey. This ain't your housewife paper porn. This book is edited by 5 different Egyptian activists. It's written through hundreds of different Egyptians tweeting. Publisher is OR Books, which I don't even know how you get started figuring out the allocation process with rights for this. Thanks for publishing this. This book basically documents the 18-day citizen uprising that ended in a revolution removing Mubarak from his 3-decade-long reign as dictator. The activists, known as Cairo's Twitterati, used social media forums to not only ignite the flame, but also to organize things. It helped with the structure creation of this whole revolution. The Egyptian people had 3 demands: removal of Mubarak, dissolving parliament and cabinet, formation of a national coalition government. In the beginning of this book, you see they wanted it to be a peaceful protest. They were reaching out, asking the world to help them. And so for 5 days, Mubarak shut down Facebook and Twitter. Shut it down. Throughout the book, you go through, you know, sadness and pride. There's such intense pride, complete and utter desperation. You also see pro-Mubarak people coming in. Coincidentally, the citizens who are pro-Mubarak, anti-revolutionaries, have NDP and police IDs. Coincidentally, they're also armed with military-grade ammunition. These guys come in and there's just bloodshed. They start shooting people. Chaos. They're also attacking foreign media. Anderson Cooper went into hiding. Our very own nation's silver fox, because Mubarak did not want foreign media to come in and see what was going on. The world was watching through social media because foreign media could not be there. I was tweeting from the front lines. I was able to because people were willing to take on the bullets as a shield, so that we could show the world what was really going on. It's bloodshed, and there's a lot of bad in this, but there's also some beautiful parts. Christians form a human shield around Muslims who are praying so that the Muslims could pray and not get hurt. Mubarak stepped down, which was such a huge triumph, but his ministers were still in place, controlling the army. Government documents state that the Egyptian military is above the constitution. We saw last year on the news, army tanks running over civilians, arresting 180. That's when they did the virgin test, because Mubarak wanted to prove that the people who were protesting were tainted people. When people actually did start to step in and say no to the Egyptian army, they did stop. It's just very raw. I'm amazed by the amount of emotion one can put into 140 characters. This book is about an 18-day uprising, and they did in fact do something. The citizens, completely fearless of their government, rose up and overthrew a 3-decade-long dictator. That's beautiful. Nobody should ever fear their government. Fast forward to now, Hillary Clinton just 3 days ago went to Egypt and Christians were throwing shoes at her head. They think that we're favoring the Christians and not the Muslims. So not all is okay in Egypt right now. Far from it. The fact that a micro society was created in Tahrir Square and ignited a nation to rise up and take back their freedom. So as of right now, they're not quite sure what their government platform is going to be. It's going to be interesting to see how this democratic transition is going to go.
Now, if you're a guy and Philip DeFranco's right, then you muted this video as you watched. In that case, I feel like it's so important for you to get the message. So,
if you have read tweets from Tahrir, then please comment down below and let me know what you think. If you end up doing it, do the same thing. Also, if you have any books that you think I might enjoy, please do comment below and subscribe. Peace, peace.